Hello, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit. You are watching YouTube channel where I upload videos for engineering mathematics B.Sc. students. I want to tell you that I have started teaching discrete mathematics and I have uploaded a video there. In second video, I'm going to discuss mathematical induction. This topic is for 11th, 12th grade. But mathematical induction is sometimes asked in discrete mathematics in exams and part of syllabus for engineering and B.Sc. students. So what is this thing? How do we do it? Meaning, if we are given any formula and we have to verify or prove whether this formula is actually correct or not, right, students? So that's what we do it here by using the mathematical induction principle. So how do we do it? Look. Suppose we have any number. Let's say it is 2n, right? It is an even number. Is that clear? If you put the value of n as 1 or 2, or n is a natural number here, ultimately it will be even. Is this really true? Is it clear? So yes, we can easily prove this here, students, by using a mathematical induction concept. Now, how will you prove it? So what we will do here in this formula, we will put 1 in place of n, right? If we will put 1, it will be 2. But 2 is even. Okay, so it's true for 1. Let's say it's true for k. So this means that the 2k number is an even number we have. Whenever there is an even number, then ultimately it will be divisible by 2 or a multiple of 2, right? Okay, so if it is true for k, now we will prove if this is also true for k plus 1. This concept is of mathematical induction. Clear? I will tell you by doing that, I will give you 2 or 3 questions for better understanding. Let's take an example and first let's take the question and try to understand it. Let's say we have a question. Question is by using mathematical induction prove that n into n square plus 5 is an integer multiple of 6 for all positive integer. Here you are being told that when you put any value of n, it will ultimately be divisible by 6, right? Or we can say any number divisible by 6 means it will be a multiple of 6. Okay, so suppose any number which is divisible by 6, so anyhow it will be a multiple of 6. Right, students? So, whenever we get multiple or divisible by 6, the point is the same, which I am explaining here. Clear? Let's say we are given this question, what we will do? Let's consider this as Pn. Pn is equal to n into n square plus 5. First, we will talk about for n is equal to 1. If we take n is equal to 1, then P1 will come, right? If we put 1, then 1 into 1 plus 5 equal to 6. And we know it is the multiple of 6, which means by 6 it will. Here, it will be divisible, which means that it is true for n is equal to 1, right? It is true for what? It is true for n is equal to 1, right? N is equal to 1. So here, students, let it be true for. Here we agree that it is true for n is equal to k. We have assumed that n is equal to k. It means that the value of pk will be. Here that will be k into k square plus 5. So what we will get here? This we have a multiple of 6. Let's assume the value that we have will be 6r. Clear, students? This means the 6r, whatever the value will be, it will be 6 into r. Only then it will be divisible by 6. This is the multiple of 6. Okay, we assume that here its value is coming to us as 6r. Now to prove. Now to prove for. N equal to k plus 1, we will do for n is equal to k plus 1, which means we will take pk plus 1. We will prove that here when k is replaced by k plus 1, right, then this will become k plus 1 whole square plus 5. I will prove that its value is also coming as 6 into something. We will prove this, getting my point. We are going to put the same concept here, let's simplify it. It will be k plus 1, we'll multiply this and open this. So it will be k square plus 2k, right, plus 1, so we will add this to 1, so it will be 6. Now, here what do you do? Multiply this. When you multiply this, you will get this k cube plus 2k square plus 6k, right? Plus k square plus 2k plus 6, you are getting my point, right? In this k cube, I will take its value from here as this is true. If I take k cube plus 5k's value or k cube's value, what do I do here? From here, I calculate the value of k cube, right? So k cube plus 5k is equal to what we have is 6r. What will be the value of k cube? It's 6r minus 5k because it's true. So I can take this value in place and we'll do the same. In place of k cube, we will place what here? When k cube is there, 6r minus 5k in this 2k and k square. So here we will have 3k square, right, students? And this is coming to us. 8k is coming plus 6, right? So when we do this, So we have 6R now. Now we can simplify this a bit. So 6R is coming. Now here we'll have plus 3K square. And here if this goes, so what will we get? It will become 3K plus 6. We will take 6R. Here we will take 3 common from here. That will make K square plus K plus 2, right? We know that this value will always be even here. You put the value of K as 1, right? If we put 1, it will be 1 and 1, 2, and 2 is 4. If we put 2, then 2 and 4 is 6. And 2 that we have here, 2 and this 4, then 6 and 2 makes 8. If you put 3, then 3 and 9, 12 and 2, 14. It means this is also a multiple of 2. You take any value of K, this will always be an even number, right? When we multiply even by 3, then we get 6. 6 is appearing here, the value will be a multiple of 6, and this is also a multiple of 6. This means this whole thing will be a multiple of 6. So it will be 6 into Q, right? This means it's a multiple of 6. So by mathematical induction, what will we have? It will be a multiple of 6, no matter what value you put here, right? If we prove it this way, I'll give you one or two more examples so you can understand. You can see the proof. So in this question, we need to prove here that this formula is for this by using mathematical induction, right? This is the value of the summation of n square. This is the formula. You have to prove it by using the principle of mathematical induction. First, students, we will talk about n is equal to 1, right? So what will we have is P1. We see that LHS and RHS value should be 1. It should be equal, right? So here, what does 1 mean? First term, right? So the first term we have is what? 1 square. That is just 1, clear? Now we put this n equals to 1 here. When you put it here, what we will get? It's 1 plus 1 and 2 plus 1 divided by 6 we will solve. This is also coming as 1, meaning LHS is equal to RHS, which means 1 is equal to K. This means that for n equal to 1, the formula that we have is true. Now, let it is true for, now we have, we saw that for 1 it is true. Now, let it is true for n. N is equal to K, we have checked for 1, it is equal. Now, we assume that this n is equal to K for this is true. When n equal to k is true, here what will come? 1 square plus 2 square, right? Plus here we have k square is equal to, what will be the value that we have? K into k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 divided by 6. Now to prove. For n equal to k plus 1, so when you make true for k plus 1, what will you get? It will be 1 square plus 2 square, right? Right plus, so here it will come k square plus k plus 1 whole square. What should be the equal of this value? If we prove it here for k plus 1, what would happen? What do you need to prove? Look at this. Wherever k is, what will come? K plus 1 will come. Write down on the side what I need to prove. If we calculate value, then what should come here? If I calculate value, what should come here? It should be k plus 1, and when we put k plus 1, then k plus 2 comes. If we put k plus 1 here, then we get 2k plus 2. So this will be 2k plus 3 divided by 6. If I get the value of this and it comes out, it means my work will be done. So we are going to do the same. What are we going to do? We will prove this, right? Now you are seeing that the value from here to here, we've assumed it. We know that this is true. N equal to k for which it's true. This value we have, I can pick it up and put it here. This will come k into k plus 1. Here, this is 2k plus 1 divided by 6 plus this will be k plus 1 whole square. I replace this with this value. I'm taking the LHS, I will prove RHS. Clear? If this is done, then my work is done, right? We talk about k plus 1. Take out common from here. See, k plus 1 is here and k plus 1 here. So what will be left? K into 2k plus 1. Plus we will be left with k plus 1. Divided by 6, we will get this. Now take the LCM of 6 here. So k plus 1, when we take the LCM of this, we will get 6. And multiplying this, we will get 2 square plus k plus 6k plus 6, right? We will simplify this, then we will get k plus 1. So here, the value of s will be 2k square plus 7k plus 6 divided by 6, right? Here, 6 into 2 is 12 and 4 and 3 is 12. The factors are more. So I'll do factors, right? Let's see what we have. Here's 2k square plus 7k plus 6. Let's find the factors, right? So what do we have here? Let's listen. It's 2k squared plus 4k, right, plus 3k plus 6. See, we can take 2k out here. So here we will have k plus 2. We can take 3 common from here. So it becomes k plus 2, right? If you take out k plus 2 as common, we will get 2k plus 3. This factor is here, we will pick it up and put it here. Here what will be the value k plus 1? Here it will become k plus 2 multiplied by 2k plus 3. Divided by 6, this was the proof we wanted to show. You understand it or not? This means here this becomes true for k plus 1. Hence, this formula is true by the principle of mathematical induction, right? So, in this way, we can easily prove this here. And this is what I tried to show you here. It's clear, students. Next question. Next is also the same type of question. It is being said that now show by the mathematical induction, this is equal to this, right? We have odd given here, right? 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square. The formula for this will be here. How will we do this? It's the same first we do is n equal to. We will do for n equal to 1 what we will do here is for. N equal to 1 will do for. N is equal to 1 here, right, students? So, here what we will have P1, right? Here LHS is 1 square and RHS. Wherever N is there, we put 1, then P1. 1 into it will be 2 plus 1. It will be 2 minus 1 upon 3. When we simplify this, it becomes 1. So, this 1 is true. So, LHS is equal to RHS, right? So, this is true. What does this mean, students? This is true for N is equal to 1. Now let it is true for, we have assumed that it is true for N is equal to K. We assume that for K, it is true. So, this is true. It will be 1 square plus 3 square, right? Plus K, here we have 2K minus 1, right? Listen, we will have 2K minus 1 whole square is equal to K. 2K plus 1 into 2K minus 1 divided by 3. So, now to prove here. Now, here we will prove that. Now, to prove for N is equal to K plus 1, we take the LHS. Here we have 1 square plus 3 square, right? So this will be 2K minus 1 whole square. Now replace K with K plus 1. So when we put K plus 1, we get 2K plus 2. So we have 2K plus 1 whole square and we need to prove its value is equal. When we take its value, then what should come here? If we take it, then what should come? Instead of K, what should we have? It's K plus 1. So when I take this, what should we have here? So, this k should become k plus 1. When we put k plus 1 here, this will be 2k plus 3. And when here instead of k, when we put k plus 1 here, then this will lead to 2k plus 1 here, right? Divided by we have 3, it should come like this, right? If I simplify it, then this value comes, so my work is done. And what should come in place of k here? K plus 1 should come. So, it's done if it comes or not, right? We know this value we have. What is it equal to? This value is equal to this, so I will keep it here. So, what will come, students? K into 2K plus 1 into 2K minus 1 upon 3 plus this would be 2K plus 1 whole square, right? See this here? It's 2K plus 1. What are we getting here? It's common, right? This will come to us K into 2K minus 1 upon 3 plus and this will come to us 2K plus 1, right? Take its LCM. So, this will be 2K plus 1. Now, we will take the LCM of this. So, here you see this is 2K square minus K plus 6K plus 3 divided by 3. We have taken the LCM of 3 here, students. Now, we will extract the value of this. It will be 2k plus 1. We will solve this. So, it will be 2k square plus 5k plus 3 divided by 6. Let's factor this. It's 2k square plus 5k plus 3. So, I'll factor it like this. What is here? This 2k square plus 5k plus 3. We know 6. We have 6 here, right? So, what we will do here? We will factor it. Here, we will have 2k square plus 3k plus 2k plus 3. Right. Here, students, k is common, so we have 2k plus 3. So, here plus 1 is common, we have 2k plus 3. Clear? So, you will see 2k plus 3 is common and k plus 1 is left. We will take this value here and put it here. So, what will we have here in this 2k plus 1 into here below we have 3, right? And this will come to us 2k plus 3 into k plus 1 divided by 3. Is it looking like this or not? Absolutely, it is. Look, here we have k plus 1. 2k plus 1, 2k plus 3, 2k plus 1 divided by 3. It's perfectly matching. That means we have this true for k plus 1. This means that this formula by using principle of mathematical induction is okay. Right. Clear. So we can do it like this. Yes. So the next question, this is a very good question. Use the mathematical induction concept. You have to prove that this is divisible by 25. Meaning its value will be a multiple of 25. It's a multiple of 25. Only then it will be divisible by 25. This is divisible by 25. You need to prove it's a multiple of 25. So, we will first write here, students, for where n is equal to 1, right? So, when we put n is equal to 1, we'll get 7 square plus 2 power. When we put 1, then power will be 0, right? This is the product here. This is the product, right? It will be with us. We will keep 3 power 1. So, this will become 0. We see the value of this is 49 and 2 power 0 is 1. Here, we know 50 is coming and we know 25 into 2 times is coming, right? So you can see this 25 into 2 times is coming. So this is coming to us. It's divisible by 25. Yes, it's okay. This is true for n equal to 1. Now, let it is true for n is equal to k. If it is true for n equal to k. So here, students, this means that 7 power 2k plus 2 power 3k minus 3, 3 power k minus 1. What will be the value? We get 25 into, we will get p type. Clear, students? Let's assume that the value is 25 into p, then only it will be divisible by 25, right? We assume it's true for k, the value we get is 25 into p. Now to prove, for n is equal to k plus 1, I will prove for k plus 1. So what will we do here? It will be 7 power 2k here, we will take k plus 1, so it will be 2k plus 2. Plus here it's 3, here k plus 1 will be then 3k plus 3, 3 cancels 3. So, what do we have here, students? 2 power where k is, we put k plus 1, it will be 3k plus 3. And 3 to 3 cancels, this will become 3k. This is 3 and here in place of k, I will put k plus 1. So, here 1 will cancel out 1, so will become k, right? We have to prove that this will also be a multiple of 25, right? So, what we do is, we take this, clear? We will take this to LHS. Now, what do we do? Here the 7 power, let's write it systematically. I will write it in this form, right? This will be 7 power 2k and into 7 power 2. I will write it like this. Okay, students. Here we have 2 to the power, right? Plus here 2 to the power. This is to 3k and I'll do minus 3. I can write here, it's 2 power 3. When we add power, it will be the same, right? In the same way, when I write this, I can write it as 3 power k minus 1 into 3 power 1. See, when we add them, it will be 3k. When we add its power to 3, I can write it like this, clear. This 7 power 2k, here when you see that 7 power 2k here, what's the value we have? How much is it? 7 power 2k's value. Take these two over there. So I will put the value here. So this will be 25p minus 2 power 3k minus 3 and 3 power k minus 1. So here, what did I do? See, listen, students. This is replaced by this. Into we have how much is coming? 49 by 7 square. So from here, we have this value as 8 and this is 3, right? So this will become 24, right? So 24 into we will have 24 into what will come here? For this 24 into this will be 2 power 3k minus 3. And it will come and multiple is coming. We get minus 3 and 3 power k minus 1, clear. We just need to multiply it. So 25p minus this will be 2 power 3k minus 3 into 3 power k minus 1. It is being multiplied by 49. So, 49 will be multiplied by this. This is equal to, it's 49 into, right? And this will also be multiplied by 49, so it will be into 49, right? Plus, now it's 24 into, right? So, 24 into will give us 2 power 3k minus 3 and 3 power k minus 1. So, listen, students, here this is 49 and this is 24, so it is minus. And plus, so when we add it, this will be 49 into 25 into p, right? So here what we have minus 49 and 24, we can take out the common. So listen, here we have this value. It will be 2 power 3k minus 3 into 3 power k minus 1. It will be minus 49 plus 24. See, the same term is common, right? We have taken it out. Here we have minus of 25, right? This will come here, 49 into 25p plus this will be 2 power 3k minus 3 into 3 power k minus 1. So we have minus 25, right? Now 25 is coming common. See, 25 is here too. 25 is common, so we take it out. This will come as 49p minus. This will come as 2 power 3k minus 3, 3 power k minus 1. So this what we have, 25 as a multiple term is coming. This means multiple of 25 will come. Here from 25, it will be divisible. This way we can prove very easily. I was trying to explain this through mathematical induction by this way. You can very easily do questions of discrete mathematics. You can do that. So it's asked in B.Sc. engineering and different exams. That's why I taught you this. I have more videos on this topic on discrete mathematics. Go check them out. This is new channel. I will be teaching for CSIR, NetGate, IIT-JAM. I will be solving questions for these exams. You can go to playlist and check it out. Listen, you can subscribe to my new channel here and you can follow me on Instagram here. Listen to the videos of discrete mathematics. How do you find them? Please do comment. Thank you for watching me. Make sure to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Press the notification bell to get notified quickly for the upcoming videos. Thank you so much.